Hey everyone, it's Dave from Dave's Ohio Barbecue. Today we are going to be reviewing the 4-probe TP25 Bluetooth thermometer from Thermopro. Stick around. In the issue of fairness, Thermopro did send me this for free, but I am under no obligation to give them a stellar review, so I will tell you exactly what I think of this after I've put it through some real-world trials. Let's start by getting to the unboxing. Okay, it's got 4 probes, Bluetooth. It says it has a 500-foot range. That I'm really tempted to see how accurate that is. Inside, you've got some instructions, and then typical Thermopro stuff. They've got their 4 probes. You've got registration cards, instructions, all that. Here's the actual like sending unit. Pretty cool. It's got this little like wire clip on the back, so it's kind of laying weird. One of the things I like that Thermopro does is on these probes right here, they give you these little reels to wind up the wires and keep them nice and like organized and safe. All 4 probes are color coded. There's a blue, a silver, a black, and a gold, and there is a port on each side, or 2 ports on each side of the actual sending unit, and they plug into the corresponding port. It also is rechargeable, and it comes with a USB cable to charge it, and 2 clips so that you can monitor the temperature of your cook chamber with 2 of the probes. Pretty cool, pretty standard stuff, looks nice, looks pretty good. It's really simple to hook up. First of all, you scan the QR code inside the instructions, either an Android phone or an Apple phone, and download the app. Turn on the unit. If it's showing a Celsius degrees, you hold down the power button for a couple seconds and it switches to Fahrenheit, or vice versa. If it's in Fahrenheit, you can switch to Celsius. And then once you launch the app, it'll ask you to have access to its Bluetooth. And then you press a pair button and it pairs with the unit really easily. That's one of the things I really like about this. It's super simple to connect to your phone. There's no complicated, you know, has to be this, has to do. It connects really, really easily, and that's something I really appreciate. Once you get into the app here, you can see that it's a pretty standard layout. You got your 4 probes here, and they're matching color coding, silver, blue, black, and gold. Okay, and you can notice here you've got an ability to set what you want that to read. So there's all these different, you know, predetermined types of meat. Let's say you want chicken and you want it to be 165 degrees, you hit set. And so now that's set to poultry. When this reaches 165, the alarm will go off. Ambient temperature, your smoker. Let's say you've got a smoker. You don't want it to go below 225 degrees, but you don't want it to go above, 275 or something like that. You can set that. Yeah, I can't get it right there, but you get the idea. Like so, okay, hit the set button, and now that one's set to ambient temperature, so it'll stay within that range. Another thing you can do, which is kind of cool, you can see here I've got a couple that say chicken thigh. If there's not a setting you like here, like for instance, there really isn't one for brisket, you can create a new target temperature, okay? So let's say I know I like to pull my briskets at 202 degrees. Oh, hold on, there we go. So at 202, and then I can name it, brisket or smoked brisket, whatever it is, okay? And then I hit save, and so now I've got this brisket setting down here, so if I want to set one of my thermometers to brisket, you can see there it is. As the time goes on and you record the time, you can hit on this little graph here and it'll show you how the temperature range. Obviously, mine hasn't done anything because it's just sitting in ambient temperature right now. But it'll show you the range if you have any spikes, valleys, stuff like that. And then you can also set an alarm. So each one of the probes has an alarm. It's just a timer. You can put comments in there. Let's say you're doing some ribs. And after the first 3 hours, you want to, wrap and sauce ribs, not necessarily in that order, okay? And then you can, start your timer, blah, 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 and you're done, Okay, so now that timer's going off, and it'll go off in, you know, 3 hours. So pretty cool. Again, all nice and neat. It connects really easy to the Bluetooth, which so far has been my favorite feature about this thermometer. Before we get too deep into this review, make sure you hit that subscribe button. Hit the little bell next to it too. That way you get notifications every time I make a new video. First, let's test the range of this. I've got a very long house. It's a ranch house, but it's very, very long. So I'm gonna go in. It easily gets all the way to my kitchen with the range without losing the Bluetooth signal. In fact, I managed to get all the way through my house into the garage and halfway down the driveway before it gave me a warning that it lost the signal. Cool thing about this is it gives you a warning when the Bluetooth signal is dropped, but there's not a lot of steps to go through to reconnect. I just started walking back the other direction and it reconnected once I got around my garage, which is pretty cool. So there's no spot really in my house that it does not connect. The 500 foot seems to be pretty accurate. Now, if you've got a house with, you know, aluminum siding or it's brick or something, and there's a lot of walls in between you and the signal, obviously the results may differ. But for me, I got a sliding glass door on my deck here, and as a straight shot into my kitchen, gives me plenty of signal. Pretty good. I like it. All right, so now I'm going to test the accuracy of this inside of my cooker. I'm cooking a couple chicken halves here. I'm going to be comparing the temperature that it reads inside of the smoker to the temperature that my smoker says it's at. There's an internal thermometer, there's actually a couple of them. And then for the meat, I'm going to be using my ThermoPen, which I know is accurate. It's been tested, calibrated 100 times. This thing is spot on, so I will test the probes to see how close they are to this. So when I got this set up for the cook, I've got the silver and black probes monitoring the meat, and I've got the blue and gold monitoring the ambient temperature, or the temperature of the cook chamber. So, and I'm gonna put the other one. Temperatures will be a little bit different, but that's okay. That, and then as for the meat probes, I'm gonna put one back here in this breast. This will be the silver one. Get in there good. And then I'm gonna put the other one up here in this thigh meat. Close up the door and let it run. You'll notice there's about a 30 degree swing between the one probe on one side of the chamber and the other. I switched them back and forth. It's not an inaccuracy with the probe. It's actually, my cooker cooks really unbalanced. So the back end of my cooker is about 30 degrees hotter than the other side, which is ridiculous, and which is why I'm looking for another smoker, because this one's not great, but it does the job. When I compared the meat probes to the ThermoPen, they were spot on. I mean, the biggest difference, I just kind of got the meat down right in the general thickness area that the other probes from the ThermoWorks were in, and they were at most a degree or two off, so I'm not really going to ding anyone on that. It seems pretty accurate. I'm also going to do the ice water test to see if all the probes read at or about 32 degrees. Before you leave a comment, I every time I do a thermometer review, I test ice water, and it usually reads around 33, 32 degrees. And people always come online and leave comments, well, if it's 32 degrees, it should be solid ice. You need to go back to high school, you need to go to physics class, and you need to review thermal dynamics, okay? When water is filled with ice and it's neither solid nor totally liquid, it hovers at about 32 degrees. That's a scientific fact. Argue it all you want, but do me a favor, before you leave the comment down below, do a little web search as to what temperature ice water should be, and hopefully you will be enlightened. I'm also going to do the boiling water test. Water boils at about 210 degrees where I am, 211, 210, right in between there. So all the probes kind of came out just around there. So pretty accurate as the thermometer goes. I like it. All right, let's go for a list about pros and cons in this unit. Some cons about this thing. I hate this little bracket thing here. It's too small to hang off of my smoker handle. I mean, I can stand it up there, but if the wires get bumped, it moves around. And I just wish there was a way to pop this off and put a big magnet, just stick it to the side of the smoker. Other cons. You know, I hate the fact that these graphics don't line up with the boxes in the middle. I know that's such a petty thing, but I come from a graphic design world and that irritates the crud out of me. What else? The battery life is pretty good. I mean, you might run out of charge if you're doing a brisket, but you can also charge it during the cook, so that's not a big deal. Pros, I like the four probes. I like that you have those little plastic reels to wind them up. That really is convenient. That's something more more thermometer manufacturers need to do, because I've got a bin of wires and I always forget which ones go with which. I put little labels on them to try to remember. And that little thing just really helps wind them all up, keep them nice and neat and organized. It's got a rechargeable battery. You don't have to worry about, you know, finding AA batteries, you know, cooking a brisket in the middle of the night. Just make sure it's charged. Plug it in the day before and you're good to go. Super cool. I also like the little light on here. Easy to change between Celsius and Fahrenheit. The range is pretty good for Bluetooth. I mean, it's really good for Bluetooth, to be honest with you. It's further than I'd ever need. Overall, it's a really great thermometer. Really big pro is the price, though. It's $60 at the time of videotaping this. Comparable ones that have four probes and are Bluetooth, you know, you're looking at $100-$120 usually, so that's a really good deal. Seems pretty rugged, seems pretty sturdy. I haven't left it out in the rain or anything yet, so if something happens to it, I will definitely update this video. As always, thanks for watching. Make sure you subscribe to me on social media. I'm on Twitter and Instagram at Dave's Ohio Barbecue. Make sure that you subscribe to my channel and hit that little bell, because I've got a lot of new videos coming out this summer. This way you'll get notifications every time I post a new one to YouTube. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.